the nature works with the qualities and creates karma. And these karmas are so powerful that you are bound to do it. You cannot choose that I will do it. No, you are bound to do it. They make you do it because they are so powerful. And that is why to know about the secret of karma is the very, very important aspect of spirituality. Like if we don't do any work, maybe our body is not moving, but our mind is in the state of motion. So we are engaged in the process of thinking. So then also we are in some action. We are engaged in some karmas or actions. So though the body is not in motion, the body is not performing any action, but we are performing those actions through our mind. And that is why it is very important for all of us to understand the secret of karma. How does it happen? Because all the time we are engaged in the process of karma. And when we are trying to go beyond the limitations of nature, we need to know that how does this nature work within us, and then only we can go beyond nature. Like here in the third verse, in this verse it says that there is no time when you do not do any work. You are always in the state of doing some work. Why? Because all these works that you do, they are performed by the nature. They are performed by the nature and the qualities. So, you know, the thing in which I am engaged all the time is done through nature. So when I am trying to go beyond nature, I also need to know how does this nature work within me. The nature is working all the time within me. And how it is working? It is always creating karmas by interacting with the qualities. When the nature is interacting with the qualities, then it is creating karmas. And when these karmas are created, we, with our ignorance, with the help of our ignorance, we think that we are the doer. Though I am not the doer, the doer is the nature. Though I am not the doer, but because this nature is working, is producing this karma through us, with the help of our attributes, our qualities, sattva, raja, tama, with these qualities, the nature is producing actions. And though I am not doing anything, I am always the observer. I am neutral always. Though I am neutral, I, with the help of my ignorance, I come to the conclusion that I am doing these karmas. So these nature and its effects are very, very deep rooted within me. If I want, I cannot get rid of this. And that is why Lord Krishna is defining the nature. See how the nature is working through you. When you talk about yoga, when you talk about enlightenment means you need to go beyond this realm of nature. You need to go beyond this phenomenon. Okay, then only you can come face to face with reality. But when I am aspiring to go beyond this, you know, beyond this realm of phenomena, I need to know how does this phenomena work within me. It is the nature which is working in me. So what is those natures? What is that nature within me which is creating karmas? We know nature means the outer nature. When we talk about nature, we talk about five basic elements. That is earth, water, fire, then wind and sky. So these are the five basic elements. This is what we call nature. From here nature has come. So this is all about nature. So it is the nature which is outside of me. When I see the nature outside, then I see nature as fire. Then I see nature as earth. Then I see nature as water. Then I see nature as sky or as wind. Now when I see nature within the body, I cannot see it inside my body. I can see everything outside my body. But though I have my eyes, but I cannot roll my eyes backwards and see what is going on inside. Now how am I able to understand what is going on within me? I understand it through my mind, isn't it? When I have mind, the mind tells me, I have a stomach pain. I have a headache. Who tells me? The mind tells me. My body is not good. My body is good. Everything is told to me by my mind. So the mind is also the nature which is experienced within this body. Okay. So mind is a nature and my intellect which discriminates, which judges the internal and the external world also is nature. So mind, intellect and ego. So these are the natures which are present within me, and the nature which is present outside of me is these five elements, basic elements. So this mind, this intellect, this ego, these three things which is called nature, they interact with the qualities. Every human being, they have a distinct quality. Somebody is rajasic, somebody is sattvic, and somebody is tamasic. Somebody is very pure. We say, this man is very pure. He is a very pure soul. Why? Because he has sattvic quality within him. He has sattvic. When I come close to him, I feel happy. I feel peace. I feel purity. I feel light. So that is how I recognize this person is a sattvic person. His actions are all sattvic. Rajasic. Any person who works for his own benefit, for his own interest. He works hard, but in this work there is an element of selfishness which is involved. So these people are called rajasic people. They are the rulers. They rule this world because they can move this world according to their mind, according to their will. They need something. They are the rulers, rajasic. And the third is tamasic. That is people who are lazy. People who does not do anything, does not do any action. They are lazy, they are sleepy all the time, they are intoxicated. These people are called tamasic people. So we see these people also. So any quality which is predominant within me, the nature works with those qualities and they create karmas. And thus a sattvic person creates sattvic karma, a rajasic person creates rajasic karma, and tamasic person creates tamasic. A person who is always sleeping will always do things by which he can only sleep. A person who does not do anything, he will always do something so that he does not do anything. he can spend his life in this tamasic way. So they create this tamasic energy, they create this tamasic karmas. So Krishna says, Lord Krishna says that the nature works with the qualities and creates karma. And these karmas are so powerful that you are bound to do it. You cannot choose that I will do it. No, you are bound to do it. They make you do it because they are so powerful. And that is why to know about the secret of karma is the very, very important aspect of spirituality. And that is why Bhagavad Gita has talked about karma and karma yoga at length. Because a person who understands karma yoga, a person who understands karma and yoga and karma yoga, for him the path towards enlightenment is easy. Understand? So he says that understand how the nature is working through you, because you are aspiring for going beyond nature. How it is working? It is always creating karmas. And though you are not doing any karma, you become the agent of this karma unknowingly. When I'm told about this, then what happens? Okay, if I don't do any karma, if I am the observer, then what is the need of doing any karma? I will not do anything. So it may come, no? That, okay, my nature is working. My nature is creating karmas. My nature along with the qualities are creating karmas. And they are working, so why should I work? Why should I get involved into the karmas? I will not do anything. Let the nature work accordingly. Let the nature work according to the way it wants to. I will not work. So here Krishna says that if you don't work, then, you know, if you don't work and if you just sit quietly, if you don't work and you sit quietly and idly, you will be a hypocrite. Because though you are sitting idly, you cannot stop your mind from working. Isn't it? And not only this, you cannot stop your mind from working. It's not only this, you cannot stop yourself being the owner of this mind. When a thought comes, it doesn't come to you that this is a thought. This is a foreign element for me. It doesn't come like this. When a thought comes to me, I know that this is my thought. I have full control. I have full association with it. Full attachment with it. So though I am not doing anything. I am not doing any work. But I am in the state of thinking. And though these thoughts are also the, you know, result of my of the nature and qualities, but when this thought comes, I cannot disassociate myself from these thoughts. I associate myself with these thoughts. I think that these thoughts are mine. Do you understand? So that is why Krishna says that there is no way. You have to do the karma. You have to do the karma knowing that you are not doing. You cannot get rid of this karma. You cannot get rid of this karma by not doing any karma. Whenever a karma comes, you have to keep on doing this, knowing that you are not the doer. Okay, so this one is saying, karma indriyani sanyamya ya aste manasa smaran. Karma indriyani, our hands, they are the sense of action. Our legs, our speech, our stomach, these are the sense of action. If I restrain their actions, I'm not moving my hands. I'm not moving my legs. I'm not talking to anybody. I'm not eating. So I'm restraining myself. I'm restraining my sense, means sense of actions. But can I restrain myself from thinking? It is not possible. I can sit idly like this. But can you stop thinking? It is not possible. So Krishna says that karma indriyani sanyamya ya aste manasa smaran. by restraining the actions of his senses. By restraining the actions of the senses, if a person keeps on with the process of thoughts, thinking, then what happens? Then it says, Indriyarthan Bimuratma. What he is doing is, he is trying to feed, nourish the desires of his senses. His senses need something, his eyes wants to see something. He is closing his eyes. Though he is closing his eyes, he is seeing those things through his mind. So what is happening is this, that he is feeding, he is nourishing his senses. Understand? I want to eat something. That is inside of me. I'm greedy. I want to eat something, but I'm not eating. I am not eating, but for the whole time, I'm thinking about that. I'm thinking about eating that particular, you know, food. So what I'm doing is, I am nourishing my senses. So if a person does not do any action, while he is always in the process of thinking, then he is nourishing his senses, and thus he is a fool. And mithyachara sa uchyate, he is a hypocrite. He is a hypocrite. He shows that he is not doing any karma, but in reality he is doing all the karmas. He's completely, you know, engaged, he's completely attached in the karma.